break. So I pull up on your doorstep. Myself, Mr. Knox, and Mr. Roger Corbett.
The activist, Mr. Cannabis. After this blunt, I'ma be so inanimate.
Your pussy an enemy fortress. Horses protecting me, Trojans.
I said I need you. Said I wanna please you, girl. Would you think I'm nuts?
Whiskeys.
I like it.
Dive bars.
I like it.
Hundreds.
I like it.
Keep jars.
I like it.
Dabbles.
I like it.
Shots.
I'll battle you on cassettes. I'll battle you on the decks. Burn a hole in your chest through a thorium vest. I'll battle you over Twitter in 140 or less.
Hi, Mom. I've become an icon. My songs are time bombs from Zion to Saigon.
Sick of staring at the mirror, wanting to punch and pull the pieces out. Wondering if anything I really say can reach the crowd.
Nobody missed ya. Nobody missed ya. Nobody missed ya.
Rappers quit saying I'm back, but no one missed.
What's up to all you MILFs and you GILFs out there on the internet? Welcome to No Coast Battles!
Yeah!
We got another battle coming up. It's been heating up on the internet by a bunch of memes.
Yeah.
This is gonna be hot. We're gonna let the battle on my left introduce himself.
What's up? My name's Kaper Lucero. Check out my album, kaperlucero.bandcamp.com. Make sure you check out nocoastraps.com. Make some motherfucking noise!
What's up, Tucker Booth? Shoutouts to the frozen food section, Tantrum Niche Records. Pick up a copy of my album, Tucker Booth for President.
Yeah!
And if any of y'all want to battle me after this in the parking lot, you know where to fucking find me.
Let's go.
There's no parking lot of this place, but I don't know what he's talking about, though.
We are, hey, what are you doing for round time?
She goes, 2.5, 3.
Man, that's long ass rounds.
All right.
Round one, Tucker Booth, let's go.
Como! I can't believe that you're fucking him! Wait, now you say you're in love with him? Now that I'm free to freak this fallacious fuckface, I'm clubbing him like he's a baby seal and I'm a right-wing Republican! Bars! Bars! Everywhere, bars! He's got bars on bars that he spits at the bar that he ripped back at the barnyard! And according to this fat sack of shite here in front of me, he's got the hard bars I should heave, like a knife on my meat. Well, Cape, hot damn, I'm sincerely in awe. Your metaphor's all maul. I think I better call Saul. Uh-huh. I'm learning from the sermon. If I really want to be the best at the brawl, I gotta rip this S off my chest and front and fest just as awful as y'all. The way your rhyme spray always leave me like, aww. He doesn't know I'm about to stuff that duck fuck till he's MC Flow de Gras. But from the look of things, Cape's done my overfeeding for me. Looks like Caper's appetite is his own worst prosecuting attorney. I keep waiting for one of your old guy Tucker fucker nursery rhymes to burn me. But to the sun, a flashlight comes off, flamer and nerdy. By the way, what's with all those pox on your face, dawg? You look more broke out than Jess Simpson circa 1998, dawg! Seriously, get some proactive or some shit on the case, dawg! Looking like the very reason not to vaccinate! Praise God! Praise God! This chicken shit is an insignificant space hog, another endless cold case for the without a trace log! And he strikes out of bars, cause chicks don't wanna meet ya with a face that looks like a meat lover Shakespeare's pizza! Now, go Google those names if they don't ring a bell, grandkids. There's a whole wide world out there past 50 Shades and those vamp twits. And Kate knows all about it. His girl reads him nightly jibs at the crib before they both go to bed celibate. Wifey dreaming about a new dick! And yes, besides being better at sex, I am a more authentic artist. Beck donkey punching you blue baby Beyonce Smurfs like Ron Artest. More punk MC surf than the damn Golden Arches. Woo! With more DIY heart than a trillion million man marches.
Yeah, you can
free at last to tap that ass, give you that bath you should have took before you came up here and rap. God, how can you smell like that? My surgical skills will remove both of those cataracts that should have been blinding you when I formally challenged dude to rap. No, your bars don't smash like the Tamps. My logic, hella evident. My legions of fans span the globe and write me in for president. Tucker Booth for president.
Yeah.
Everybody loves the sound of that.
Kaper for president.
Sounds like an alcoholic clownish act. Maybe Shakes and Bozo and Krusty can rep you around town with that. President of the Jesters, Mimes, and Hacks Union for recovering faggot cats. Now, Nancy Pants. We samurais empathize with the fact, but we'll still slash your skull by default to format and use pushover pipsqueaks like you as a welcoming doormat. Yeah. Wipe my shoes on your carpet and leave a Cleveland steamer in the john. Oh. Then carve cold cuts from your carcass and serve them as finger foods at your kid's prom. Oh. You make awful raps if that's what you call a track. I won't hesitate to diss you. Jaws get cracked, sawed in half, the same blade of Ginsu made to split you. Your type of act is flawed and flat, drinking disaster's piss, dude. I hate your shit like the Patriots. Don't try and deflate our issues. And Kate, I'm a Christian, but goddamn, you're up here trying to body the champ, built with cankles like the fucking Michelin Man. If you want to be the champ, you must stay upright and vigilant, man. And last I heard, you got caught trafficking kids from Japan in your motherfucking miniature van. Dude, your rhymes taste sloppy, flavorless, and dull. I am Leviathan. I'm devouring your soul. More breath control, soul, cold flow. You're out of control. The God of War, I use this troll skull as a fucking cereal bowl! Time.
Round one.
Go!
You're the president,
you're
Let's go!
Hold it down!
Shut up!
Hold it down, hold it down. I'm like, holy shit, in real life you sure are a real ugly fuck. I'll uppercut you after I cut you in a tummy tuck. This is the fucking guy from Silence of the Lambs wearing somebody's skin. This weirdo probably even dances in front of the mirror tucking it in. You slept on me and shit the bed. You smell like shit, Tucker. I ain't Smokey back here taking a shit, but you ain't Chris Tucker. This is gonna be the last time you rap. You're about to fade from the scene. It's ironic your last name is Booth when a booth is the last place you should be. They hear you sing, but they don't give a fuck what's your name. You just stand at a guitar with an open case, bumming change. Well, change comes from within, Tucker. You need to get a real job for once. You've been on unemployment. Well, I'm employed a month. I come up from the fucking gutter. You had privilege and I had hunger. So how am I more of a grown-up than you when I'm 10 years younger?
That's a lie. That's a fucking lie.
Shut the fuck up. Seriously. This might be my only chance to say my opponent is older than me. You're the frozen food section, right? Well, I'm absolute zero. You ain't colder than me. Woo! When you decided to be a spiritual gangster, you must have been drunk and high. Those stupid-ass poons go great with your childlike haircut and your sunken-in eyes.
Get him!
I mean, come on, old man. Where's your robe and your house shoes? Your nostrils are so long, your nose is in the bathroom trying to do coke without you. You want to be a folk singer, song? Shut up! Shut up! You want to be a folk singer, songwriter, comedian, hippie actor? Slash mystical forest wizard ninja shitty rapper? Hey, this thrifty bastard's the missing link in evolution. There's no further to search. You look like you could be Grizzly Adams' family's version of Lurch. Your wife wears the shirts and the pants and she's the breadwinner. And you're the stay-at-home dad that makes garlic bread for dinner. Well, you give me listeners on a weekly, so honestly, I gotta thank you, bro. It's a real honor you play my music on your online community radio.
You're welcome.
But I don't know what makes you think you would ever have fucked with me. I'll give you a frontal lobotomy with the bottle in front of me. I'll wrap you, put you in a bag, and serve you like a cold cut trio. This is like when Jordan Thompson Mutombo closed his eyes and made the free throw.
Truly didn't think Tucker Booth was gonna come and run the jewels on him in Como. Snuck in and stole his stilo and butt-thumped that shit, no homo. And I got it on good authority, Kaper's ready, willing, and able to suck golf balls through a garden hose and take probes in his a-hole. Face it, fuckboy, you've had two battles in your entire career. I had two battles on the commute from St. Louis to here. In the first one, you beat a doughboy who was obviously unprepared. Then got mollywopped in the second one like you weren't even there. Dude, fucking fucking sad the way X called you out on your shit. Fucking got your balls kicked in the way your ex called you out on your shit! Dude, this fucking loser douche is Mitt Romney. I'm the man like Ron Paul. Only Opie sounds more dopey with that Gomer Cable guy drawl. Jeff Foxworthy, except without the fame, money, or jet set. If you think Kaper is tight, you might be a redneck. I mean, come on, man, you know that's true. Check his album, Put On Track 2. It's fucking whack. This dude's made country rap with Pat Boone. Sets traps, eats dogs and cats, and wears ugly hats made from dead raccoons.
Let's go.
And besides blue collar cape, you're equal parts traitor. Cause it's clear from your career that you ain't smarter than a fifth grader. You're Jar Jar Binks, I'm Darth Vader. You speak in black patois, Al Jolson, blackface, race baiter.
Hey, it's February, sir.
This fucks Jonah Hill and Django Unchained. Can't even cut the eye holes right on his hood. Now the Klan's having him slain. And I just came here tonight to kill the reason for the urge to continue this killing season. Fuck it! United we purge! Kate? Hi, I'm Rob Lowe, and I have DirecTV. This is sad monkey-ass clown Kaper. He's got cable. Come at me, bro. I'm ready and willing for the grilling. Cause we all know Hot Rob Lowe's triller than that cable you're shilling. Rob Lowe? This fatty fat fat is Blob Lowe. So overweight, he gets disability benefits at Costco. And I know you want the beard, but you can't handle the beard. You stutter and stammer and blather and fear, babble and blunder while I'm grabbing the cheer, bodying you on your home court, which is sadder than the fact that you're queer. This bitch wiggle winning, fuck out of here. Time.
Grab someone.
All right, shut up. All right. He's so old school, I call him Grandpa Master Flash when I make fun of him. Dog, you're so old school, the school you attended had corporal punishment. Dog, you're so old school, you tell old school stories when you live in the past. You're so old school, the school you attended didn't have a history class. So I'm gonna teach him a lesson and rock him with internal rhymes. He's gonna bleed from my weapon when I chop him, it'll hurt inside. He wanna sing like George Clinton from the hip hop he's loved to learn in life. So it's gonna be a lethal injection like the bop gun sample we heard from Ice.
Kill
him. I'm like, fuck the police, fuck the police, fuck them. People mad at cops. I'll take my finger Glock, lock and pop, and watch him pop and lock like Planet Rock. These are the breaks. Sucker MCs get made a fool. I know you got soul, Tucker, but you ain't paid in full. The only reason why you're standing there, it takes two. This is gonna be the last battle when they reminisce over you. This is strictly business when I give you this death sentence. Don't push me cause I'm close to the edge and this is the message. I'm gonna bar your life away, scheme your life away, rhyme your life away, write your life away, pawn your life away, punch your life away. And if your kids grow up to battle me in the future, then your kids will grow up the same way. Ooh. Since your kids will grow up the same way. Cause I don't even know you as a person, so fuck your truth. You get the two-piece like I'm chucking up a double deuce. I'm having an out-of-body experience looking down from up above at you. I'm hovering metaphysically over this hippie to drop a spiritual number two. You look like you own like 9 pairs of running shoes.
Let's go.
No, wait, no, wait. You look like you haven't slept in a month or two. Your face looked like a bunch of people kicked it and punched it too. You have the swag of a kid that was raised by a couple dudes. You take your wife out to dinner with the change that you bum for food.
Oh my God!
You're an atheist racist, but somehow look like a Christian Muslim Jew. I'm gonna be murking this pussy like his mother after she cut her pubes. On the count of three, I need everybody to say, fuck you to Tucker Booth.
Fuck!
1, 2, 3.
Fuck you to Tucker Booth!
Yeah. Fucking douche.
We got fuck you, Tucker. Round, fuck you, man.
Make some noise for that round.
Yeah. Shut up!
By the way, when's this battle gonna start? I thought body bags were in order. From the sound of shit, you're bound to spit till we all die of bed sores or traumatic whackness disorder. This whore's Michael Moore, poking holes in the sniper. Vomiting hot piles of poppycock schlock in the cipher. Eddie's a skate poser. Phony Hawk. Chad Muskrat. Wee Man's Fluffer, the one who asshole hoops Margera's stuff sack. And his sexual profile keeps him 500 feet away from skate parks and makes him check in with his PO every afternoon before dark. Dude, you ain't street bro. Certifiably weak flow. This frittata can't even do an ollie or primo. That's why real skaters treat this freak show like a somewhat no. Much fatter Don Vito! Now look, back to X.
Yeah.
Always back to X.
Always.
Kate, as far as XQZ goes, Sugar Britches, you got X'd out. Took the motherfucking exit in the motherfucking first round. You shit the bed. And what's worse, it's driving you berserk. Sitting around the house soaking like those rhymes I wrote when I was 16 didn't work. Dude, simmering and whimpering like, ain't that a bitch? Got your balls kicked in the way your ex called you out on your shit. The best part about that ex shit was watching you lose control, looking out of place like that left shark at the fucking Super Bowl. Dude, every letter more clever than you could ever hope to endeavor. You can't even handle your X's, Q's, and Z's, but you think you can hang with me phonetically? This douche needs spell check to spell check. He makes spelling error, telling the fight crowd to pipe down so things will be fairer. Dude, that body bag was like watching Dr. King drag to the cemetery while X bodied you by any means necessary. Dude, you really think losing with no prep makes you a man of respect? Why don't you ask these college kids or Tucker Booth how to handle your ex? Shit. You better bring your best bars, bud, because the next part's hella true. X didn't mark the spot, bitch. X and Tuck marked you.
Hold it down!
You are the greatest.
Bars. Time.
Time. Time. Round three on Kaper.
All right, y'all want to hear the story?
Yeah.
All right, so I shared a battle online and this weirdo commented awkwardly, asking me if I would have a poetry fight with him obnoxiously. I emailed him my number about a battle and within 5 minutes he was calling me, and you wouldn't believe how long this fucking asshole tried to soapbox to me. Now normally a phone call is like 5 minutes tops, but he just kept going on and on and on and on and on and on. The shit didn't stop. But I was gathering information, so I was like, uh-huh, and just let him talk. And for 2 hours, he tried to prove to me that he was real hip-hop. Dude, you said that Scribble Jam 2004, you freestyled with a no-shirt, an acoustic guitar, and flip-flops. Really? You said you beat Mike and Nine in 95 battling in a vinyl thrift shop. Really?
Freestyle fellowship.
You said you used written rhymes in freestyle tournaments you won in the final 3 rounds. Really? So that really means your Slumfest trophies don't even really count, really? I mean, he's really 41 years old and really said, I think I'm gonna make it. He told No Coast, don't worry about a plane ticket because his parents will pay it. For a living, you bums change. Shut up. For a living, you bums change. For a living, you bums change while playing guitar on a side street. Because he got fired from being a teacher for sniffing little kids' bike seats. What you know about full benefits or compounded interest accounts? He'd be sleeping on Shy John's couch if he didn't leech up his spouse. She makes the money and cooks, so you're the bus boy of your family. Why in the fuck you tell me all that shit knowing you had to battle me? I guess the lesson for the night is don't be a naive asshole. How can you call Jared your protege if he's beat you every time you battle? You're the least talented narcissist I've ever actually met, and this ain't even a fucking battle, it's a reality check. You want to know that you said on the phone that pissed me off the second most? You actually told me you thought of this battle as a personal stepping stone. The joke is he's really trying to battle T-Dub. You showed me your hidden intentions. When you hinted at No Coast putting 3 stacks up for that battle, shit, you need to forget it. You pay for that. That's on you, faggot. You said they pushed you out the St. Louis battle rap scene because you were white. Well, I think they pushed you out the St. Louis battle rap scene because you aren't tight. If you knew I came from an interracial family, it would have been a different conversation. But you said some shit that got me convinced that you're just an ignorant racist. I'm not your clan, brother motherfucker. I just want that to be clear. Why don't you go back to California, you hippie faggot? We don't like your kind around here. Shut the fuck up.
Homophobe.
Hey, see, that's what ignorance sounds like. So if that's what you're trying to hear, you should have locked yourself in the fucking walk-in closet and battled yourself on the fucking mirror. Time!
Angriest battle, No Coast history, NoCoastRaps.com. Thank you, EastSide. We're out of here.
My name's Kaper and shit.
EastSide XQZ.
Shake Zula, bitch.
One more time, make some noise, No Coast!
Yeah, okay.
That's all they ever say to me.
Yeah, okay.
Thinking everything is always make-believe.
Yeah, okay.
That's all I've ever heard.
Yeah, okay.
They don't believe a word.